Got Talent, you would be forgiven for thinking that they would be part of Simon Cowell's troupe. But in fact, it was their nan that was the inspiration. The brothers join us now. But first, we're going to listen to their work before we talk to them.
There's a time for everyone if they only learn that the twisting kaleidoscope moves us all in turn. There's a rhyme and reason to the wild outdoors when the heart of this star-crossed voyager beats in time.
Nan loves that one, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does.
She's a big fan.
Absolutely.
Is that her favourite? I mean, does she have a favourite?
I'd say that's the favourite for Nan. I think, well, I remember as a kid going down to, she used to live in Birmingham, she lives in Wales now to be close to the family. And we used to go down there for the 6 weeks holidays, and we used to spend every single day with like a new sort of musical film, whether it be Disney. And I've got this image of The Lion King every single day. And I remember one summer holidays as well, we also did The Sound of Music. And I remember going back to school and everyone was like, oh, so guys, you know, what have you been doing? And I was like, yeah, no, The Sound of Music back to back. And they were like, really? We've been playing football. I'm like, oh.
You know, it's quite unusual for pop stars, you know, you ask them their inspiration and very few say their nan. And very few then go on to have careers specifically focused on a certain generation. They want to appeal to people more their age. And you've done something completely different. Yeah, going around helping people's homes.
We listened to a lot of like Michael Bublé and stuff when we were younger, and we loved pop music and things, but it was Nan who heard the voices in us, and she said to us, listen, I think you could sing classical singing, because she loves it. She loves Mario Lanza and all that. And I remember she put the three tenors for us singing at the Paris game, and we were listening and we absolutely loved it. And both of us got that goosebump moment, and Nan was going, you've got to sing this stuff. And Nan really is the inspiration.
Nan,
so.
We are seeing Nan. What's Nan's name?
That's June.
That's June, yeah. Okay. That's the Nan that was on Britain's Got Talent. And that's really why we're doing the Age UK tour, because she suffers from dementia and also Parkinson's. It's been very difficult for the family because she was sort of the heart of the family. And we wanted to sort of do something for her. So, you know, we phoned up management and said, is there anything we can do to sort of raise some money or awareness for dementia and Parkinson's? And they, you know, they got in contact with Age UK and have given us the opportunity to go out and do something for her.
Well, and
really,
you'll have seen firsthand from your work, the music is an amazing tool, isn't it?
Oh,
for,
yeah.
I mean, just for giving people, I don't know, some comfort or
absolutely
a lift of some kind.
Well, doing this Age UK tour, when we've been going and singing the songs, it's amazing. The people with dementia and stuff have just been singing and trying to sing, and then the people are coming up to us after saying we haven't heard them do that for so long.
It can trigger a lot.
Yeah,
I think
my theory on it is when you're talking to someone with dementia, I think they find it quite stressful to talk back, and they're trying to communicate, whereas music, you can just sit back and listen. And I think that's really where the communication comes, especially with Nan. I mean, you stand next to Nan and sing, you know, Can You Feel the Love Tonight or Moon River, and she's just with you.
Yeah, she
and
is.
She's following the tune, and it's incredible.
Tell us a bit about the album, because the album is movie themed.
Yes.
Just give us a selection of the ones you...
We're sort of massive fans of films. We've got stuff like Everything I Do on there, Kiss From a Rose,
Moon River.
It's done in an opera style, isn't it?
Yeah.
So you're not operatically trained?
No, we're not. Basically, I spent hours and hours and hours a day on the computer, because when I worked in the sandwich shop, I was only on about £150 a week, and I inquired about lessons. They were like, it's going to be like £50-60 an hour. I was like, can't do that. Can't make that. So what we've trying to do now in the last sort of few weeks is go to trained opera singers and try and get that extra bit of one-to-one tuition as well as sort of my own.
It's amazing how certain songs, you know, that you think wouldn't work as a classical style, when we go down and Sony put them together, we listen, we were like, it works so well, but you didn't think it would. It's amazing. We're really happy with it. Really,
you're bringing
happy.
A lot of joy.
Well, thank you for coming this morning. Good luck with the tour. I'm sure you're going to bring a lot of joy to a lot of people.
Mid-February to sort of mid-March, and fingers crossed. We did a tour earlier this year, and it was brilliant. We love being able to sing to the audiences, so we're waiting for round two.
Thanks, guys.
Okay, the new album, Richard and Adam at the Movies, is out on Monday.
Speaking to Lewis Smith.